demonstrate how easy it is to set up an Azure backup process. We're on the Azure portal, and the hardest part is actually finding the backup process. So you want to go up to the top in the search box and type in recovery services and pick that recovery service vault option. From there, you want to add a new vault, and we're going to call it what's called a friendly name, something that you'll remember. This can be as small as 2 characters or as many as 50 characters. For purposes of this demo, I'm just doing a test backup, so that's what I'm going to call it. You're going to assign it a subscription. There are some demo subscriptions you can sign up for. You're going to pick a resource group or create a new one. And again, I'm just doing a test backup here, so I'm just going to call it a test name. So I'm going to delete this when I'm done. And then you're going to pick a location where you're going to store it. I'm in the Pacific area, so I'm going to pick West, but you can see that there's all sorts of places. If you need to be geographically in a certain area, you can pick. And then you hit Create, and it's going to start creating the vault. And up in the upper right-hand corner, it indicates what the process is or what the progress is of that vault. And you may need to hit Refresh, because when it's done, you have to hit Refresh to see it. And once it's there, you can then click on it and launch it to set up the backup. So we're going to click on Backup because we're going to start the backup process. And we're going to pick where our workload is, what we want to back up. In my case, I want to do an on-premise backup. And I want to pick what I want to back up. You can do system state, bare metal recovery, files and folders. For purposes of this demo, I'm only going to do files and folders. Then I'm going to prepare the infrastructure. And we're going to download the Microsoft Azure agent, what's called the Mars agent. And we're going to install it on this machine because I'm actually doing it on this machine itself. And if it doesn't have a certain prerequisite, it downloads it. So obviously it needs Visual C++ 2012 redistributable. And there's a certain version of .NET that it needs as well. And then you pick where you're going to install the location. If you go through a proxy server, you'll need to enter that. If you need a .NET 4.5, it would download that and install that. I already had that on this Windows 10 machine. But if, let's say you were on a Windows 7, it would download the 4.5. It installs what it needs. And now we're ready to register the device up in the backup service. So now we need to provide what's called vault credentials. And you go back to your infrastructure page. And because we've already installed the latest agent, we're already ready to go. So you click on that box and you say download. And it will download the credentials to your machine. You want to save it someplace on your machine so you can get to it. I tend to use downloads a lot. I probably shouldn't use that folder anymore, but especially in 1809 where it tries to clean up that folder. So now you go back to your vault identification and you find your credentials and you upload that. I usually pick generate a passphrase and then I store that. You'll probably want to put that in an Azure Key Vault. For purposes of this demo, I'm just putting it down on this machine. Again, for best practices, you want to store it in another location. So look into that Azure Key Vault. And then it's registering the server with the Azure backup. Now this part usually takes the longest, and you kind of sometimes think, is it working? It really is working. Give it time, be a little bit of patient. For me, it takes about a minute for this process to occur on a normal beefy machine. And even then it's not that exceedingly long. But just be a little patient in this process as it registers the computer up on the network and gets it ready to go. And now it's ready to start the backup process. And as you can see, it's just like a normal Windows backup where you select and schedule the backup and you select the files that you want to back up. As you can see, the interface is very, if you've ever done a normal Windows backup, the interface is very, very familiar. Again, in this case, I'm only doing a test, so I'm just going to do a quick and dirty download file backup. You want to pick when it's going to back it up. And as you can see, it has a very healthy retention policy. And then you want to do it over the internet. You can use what's called Azure Data Box. We'll get into that later. And there you go. It's creating the backup schedule. And it's done. And it's ready to go.